Hey guys, DZF here, and today I'm going to be answering questions that I received about my spirit deck. Obviously, I can't answer all of them in one video. I did try to reply to most of them across various mediums, including Facebook, the video on my channel, and the video on Cordero's channel. I would also like to humbly thank Cordero for giving me the shout out. I know a lot of people I saw asking him to give themselves deck profiles, but I didn't really ask for it. He contacted me after I had sent him, or I told him that I did win with spirits because we were talking about it the previous day, and he asked if he could promote my channel and deck, and I just really want to thank him for that, and also for the overwhelming support of the viewers. Overall, my comments were generally positive, and that's really great. Seeing the Yu-Gi-Oh! Day deck profiles, this was probably the most outlandish deck there was, and I'm really happy that people liked it, and that I didn't get too much hate, I could say. And of the people I did get hate, most of them hadn't played the deck at all, and once I pointed that out to them, in general, they were had a change of heart, and that's really cool. So, answering the biggest questions about this deck, the number one definitely was about the Blue Eyes engine. This is definitely mostly coming from people on the ARG page and Vexicus's channel, not so much my video. The Blue Eyes engine did not work as well as I had thought it would be at all. In previous testing, why it works is if you don't open with Aritama or Nikitama, you were kind of stuck, so Maiden could buy you a lot of turns. The problem with this in the build that I topped with was that the day before the event, I decided to add four level fours. I added Yaksha, the other fairy guy like Rasetsu, Thunder King, and Kaiku. So these guys basically took the spot as Maiden, where if I don't open Aritama, at least I have another normal summon that's still good. So throughout the weekend, I summoned Blue Eyes three times. Two of those were from Silver's Cry, and one of those was from Lancing a Maiden. And that's not a lot of times if you consider five rounds and a lot of games. I think like 12 games. Because, yeah. Anyway, so I didn't summon Blue Eyes very often, and I'm definitely going to be dropping the engine. I did side out every game. I mentioned this in my video. I sided out one Blue Eyes, one Maiden, and one Silver's Cry every single game. It gave me three slots to work with as far as side decking goes. And yeah, I opened Blue Eyes, I think, four times throughout the tournament. And I should mention that if you want to read the tournament report, I will eventually put it in the description of this video, but it will be uploaded on TCGplayer.com, I think Tuesday or Wednesday, so you can look forward to that. The next most commonly asked question was, why no creature swap? So the night before, Jeff Jones, if you don't know him, you probably know him, we were talking about spirits, and he showed me his build, and he was playing three creature swap and three mystic box. Mystic box is a card where you destroy your opponent's monster and then give them a monster of your own, and I personally didn't like creature swap in testing beforehand, so I chose not to run it. Right before the tournament, like in the store, I considered playing it, but I hadn't really tested with it with the new monsters and stuff with the four new level fours, so I didn't want to take my chances in that case. Looking back on it, I do not regret not playing creature swap. It's not a bad card. I'm currently testing a lot of the stuff people suggested to test, so that's one of the cards that I'm working on right now. It's not a bad card. It's just not a great card. Right now, it's looking like I'm going to be playing one, because the biggest problem with this deck, a lot of people bash it for being inconsistent. It's not actually inconsistent. It's one of the more consistent rogue decks out there. You have a lot of search power. You have a lot of cool combos to like gain a ton of advantage. The biggest problem is that you have a lot of cards, especially when you're playing Blue Eyes, that require other cards to work. This is going to be a common theme when I'm answering the other questions about cards. I wanted to play as few cards as possible that required me to have other pieces of a combo. This is not a combo deck, so it doesn't play like a combo deck, which means, you know, you don't want to have all these cards that you can't do anything with unless you have something else. This was the problem with the Blue Eyes cards, where Blue Eyes didn't do anything on its own, Silver's Cry didn't do anything on its own, Maiden did stuff on its own, but Maiden took up a normal summon. As of looking at the deck list right now, the only big thing that takes like combo pieces is Nikitama, and Nikitama isn't even that bad because you can have literally any other spirit monster and it's just fine. So Creature Swap is just another card where if you draw it in multiples, you kind of just lose, and it's kind of slow and restricts your plays, but I'm testing multiple numbers of them out right now. It's definitely just looking like I'm gonna end up playing one, but yeah, that was one of the probably the biggest comment. Another one that got asked a lot was, why no Kinkabayu? So, the real reason I did not put Kinkabayu was because it did not come in the mail in time. The mail at my school is really slow. They get the mail through the mail room, and then it gets to us like 3 days later. So, I had ordered Kinkabayu, and it didn't get here, so I had to change up my build, like, four cards beforehand. Actually, I changed it, I think, eight cards the night beforehand, and Kinkabayu was one of those. Looking back, though, I 100% am glad I did not play Kinkabayu. A lot of people playing Spirits or playing Mystic Piper Engine, I think a defensive level 4 approach is just infinitely better. Continuing on the theme of Creature Swap, and even Blue Eyes for that matter, Kinkabayu is a card that requires you to have other cards, so if you draw it early on, it's pretty much awful, and without Maiden, it just doesn't have like a lot of synergy with anything. You don't play enough level 1s to make it worthwhile. You can definitely play like Swift Scarecrow, and you already play Valor, and you can play Mystic Pipers. But I mentioned this in a comment to someone. If you play those cards, your first Mystic Piper only has like a 1 in 4 chance of getting the extra draw. And just to that's assuming you don't open any of their level 1s. And it just kind of goes down as you go through more level 1s. So I like to play Mystic Piper in decks where I have a crap ton of targets, and the real like reason you play Piper is to get a plus off of it, not just one for one, and I can't play it for that reason because I wouldn't play enough level 1s, and if I did, it wouldn't be a spirit deck, so I really like the traps in this deck, and a lot of people, when they're playing spirits, don't seem to be playing a lot of traps, and I'm not sure why. You need back row defense, not only to prevent yourself from losing when you're setting up your plays, but also like a lot of I'm playing 3 MST, 2 traps done in the main, and 2 dust tornado on the side. You want to make sure you can go through your opponent's back row so that your spirit monsters don't get screwed up and your chaos monster summons are okay. Also hitting stuff like Tenki and Grand Spellbook Tower, as well as like Gyrgia Gears before they resolve, is really important to winning, so that's why I don't play Kinkabayu. Continuing on with more spirit monsters, Dark Dust Spirit was also suggested quite a bit. A lot of people seem to think that Nikitama, like his main goal when they created him, was for tribute summon monsters, because you can normal summon him and then tribute him, and then you get to draw a card because you have a spirit monster on the field and the spirit monster does things. And while I agree that that might have been the case, I think even looking at the artwork, you can clearly see that the interaction that was mainly supposed to be done is Nikitama and Aritama interacting. And just in general, I like keep going back to this. The level 6s, while not quite as dead as Blue Eyes in hand, they just aren't like nearly as good. That also goes for the bird thing, which I have a picture of it up right now. I don't actually know how to pronounce that at all. It's basically a Dark Dust Spirit for back row. Both these cards are totally dead if you don't have Nikitama. Like, I don't think people understand that. You can't... I might make a video about spirits, like, in depth so people kind of understand the strategy. Like, I've talked about them a lot because I wrote an article about them. It's going to be posted today, and then I'm going to write the tournament report that talks about some changes, and I'm making this video. But the key thing to winning with spirits is not burning through your spirits. Oftentimes, I would play super conservative, even against aggressive decks like Heretic Rulers and Inzectors. Actually, I played pretty much all aggressive decks at the tournament. But you can't just like willy-nilly burn through your Nikitamas with your level sixes. So summoning Nikitama, and instead of like summoning Yaksha and bouncing something, or summoning Aratama and plusing, and then but just tributing it for a tribute monster, that's technically still just a zero because you're going to draw off Nikitama, but they're just not good standalone cards. And I think a lot of people that commented that do not test the deck at all, and that's kind of a problem. They just say, hey, spirits, why aren't you playing all the spirits that are out? Same reason why I don't run all seven Crystal Beasts and Crystal Beasts, because they're all, like, half of them are just terrible. Same reason I only run two Volcanics and triples in a Volcanic deck and one Slicer, because you don't need to play every card of an archetype or a type to make a deck around it. And I think people forget that spirit isn't an archetype, it's a, like, subtype, so you can't, they don't, they're not all meant to work together. And I mean, there's very different spirit decks. There's ones where you can play the high levels, like the 8 and the 7, the one that draws you 5 cards and the one that discards 5 cards, and then you can play the one that prevents your spirit monsters from bouncing back to the hand in the end phase. But you wouldn't combine that with this build because you want your stuff bouncing back to the hand in the end phase. You want to repeatedly use Yaksha's effect and repeatedly use Aratama's effect. That's like the goal. So there's two very different spirit playstyles. One that, okay, so for looking at spirit monsters, there's basically two types of spirit monsters. There's a type that has the effect when they're normal summoner, they all get effects when they're normal summoner flip face up, but there's a type where you want them to repeatedly return back to the hand to continuously use their effects, and that is the other type of spirit monsters where you want them to stay in the field because their effects are so good, and their effects are something that happens not when they're normal summoned. So the higher levels are the ones that you want to stay in the field because that kind of stuff. But anyway, so that covers all of that. The last card I'm going to talk about is something called Izanami. I think I'm probably butchering that name. Good thing I don't care. This is something that someone suggested to me. I'm pretty sure only one or two people suggested it. Thank you so much for suggesting this. I kind of just faded over this card when I was looking through spirits to play. Like, honestly, adding Yaksha and the Rasetsu guy was just a last-minute decision anyway. So reading this one, I'm just like, well, how can this be good? But it is actually really cool. You can summon it and discard a Nikitama if you have a spirit monster in grave to add the Nikitama back and then still draw a card. This interaction was posted in the judge group, and most of the judges ruled it that even if you grab back the Nikitama that you discarded, you still get the draw. I would still ask a regional head judge or a YCS head judge before you actually go about doing that. But when I was testing this last night, because I did get a little chance to play some Dueling Network, one of the cooler plays was when you have a Nikitama in hand, or if you have a Nikitama or a Izanami, stupid names, but if you have either of them in hand and you set an Aratama and your opponent doesn't attack it, next turn you can flip up Aratama, summon this thing, Izanami. Like, why are they named so stupidly? And then you can discard Nikitama to add it. You can either add it back to your hand, or you can add a different monster to your hand, draw a card, and then make a rank 4. That's really cool. What's even cooler is if you have two Nikitamas in hand with this thing, and or if you have just, like, one Nikitama, one of this thing, and you search the other Nikitama, then you can actually flip Aratama, summon Nikitama, summon this thing, discard Nikitama to add something back, draw a card, overlay Nikitama and Aratama for, like, Silent Honor's Arc, for an example, detach, steal something, draw another card, and then you can pass back to your opponent. This goes back to your hand, and then you can do, like, another combo next turn, and that's really cool. That came up a few times, and I thank you for whoever suggested this. I don't actually have the names of these people, because this video is just about taking the general comments that I got overall. I covered pretty much everything I wanted to in this video. Sorry, it was kind of long. I'm probably going to make a channel introduction video because I got over 100 subscribers in the past day. We saw my last like 5 videos get almost double, triple the views that they had beforehand. All thanks to Cordero and his I want to say hospitality. That's not quite the right word. But him being nice and giving me a huge shout out across a bunch of different platforms. So if you came for spirits and want to know what my channel is about, you can check out that video. I do a couple different segments on here, and I play a lot of different decks that are kind of underwhelming. That's not a good word, because that means they're bad. I do a lot of decks that are underappreciated, I think is a better word. And yeah, I would enjoy if you check out my videos. I don't really require you to. I'm not making money off of it, so I don't care too much. But thank you for subscribing, and hopefully this answered a lot of the questions about this deck. Bye.